The overhead power lines are connected to the towers or poles through insulators. There are different types of insulators, including pin type, suspension type, strain, and shackle. In this video, I'm going to explain these types one by one. Hi, I'm Vanilla, and you're watching The Learning Curve. Let's start with the pin type insulators. Pin type insulators are mounted on the cross arms of the poles with the support of pole top pins. A lead thimble is cemented into the insulator body to receive the pin. If you look at the top of the pin insulator, you'll find a groove, or in other words, a narrow cut on it. The power lines pass through this groove. To secure the power lines, they are tied to the insulator using the same material as the power line. The main purpose of the insulator is to block the current that flows in the power line to enter the transmission pole. Therefore, very high electrical resistive materials are used in the manufacture of these insulators. Some commonly used materials for the insulators of the overhead lines are porcelain, glass, and polymer. We expect these insulators not to allow the current to flow through them at any circumstances. Do you think these insulators will fulfill our expectation? To know the answer, we must be familiar with the term electrical breakdown. It is the process when a high voltage is applied to an insulating material, it suddenly acts as a conductor. The voltage at which the insulator fails to block the current is called the breakdown voltage. The breakdown voltage depends on various factors, and one of them is the size of the insulator. That's why for different voltage power lines, we use different insulator sizes. For low voltage, a single piece insulator is used, and for high voltage, two or more pieces are cemented together. As the voltage increases, the size of the insulator gets bigger. Beyond the operating voltage of 33 kV, the pin type insulator becomes too bulky and hence uneconomical. So, the pin type insulators are used at voltages up to 33 kV. Even after designing an insulator, considering all these factors, there are times where we cannot avoid the electrical breakdown. The electrical breakdown occurs as either a flashover or a puncture. In a flashover, an arc occurs between the power line and the insulator pin through the air, while during puncture, the arc travels through the insulator body. Therefore, when the insulator breaks down by puncture, it is permanently damaged. We cannot use that insulator anymore. We need to replace it with a new one. But the insulator is not damaged by a flashover. To avoid a puncture, a sufficient thickness of porcelain is provided in the insulator. The ratio of puncture strength to the flashover voltage is known as safety factor. The value of the safety factor should be high so that the flashover takes place before the insulator gets punctured. For pin type insulator, the value of the safety factor is about 10. As I said earlier, beyond 33 kV, we cannot use this pin type insulators. So for high voltages, suspension type insulators are used. They are generally used with steel towers. Suspension type insulator consists of several insulated discs connected in series by metal link in a form of a string. The conductor is suspended at the bottom end of the string, while the other end of the string is secured to the cross arms of the tower. Each disc is designed for a voltage rating of 11 kV. The number of discs in a series depends on the operating voltage. For example, if the working voltage is 66 kV, then 6 discs in series will be provided on the string. If one disc is damaged, it can be replaced with a new one. But whenever the transmission line changes direction, we cannot use the suspension insulator. In such cases, either strain or shackle insulators are used. For high voltage lines, strain insulators are used, and for low voltage, shackle insulators are used. The disc of the strain insulators are used in a vertical plane. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.